Está en la cabina de RMX para platicar de esta nueva visita a México, Teresa Wyman, de Warpaint. Teresa, it's a pleasure to have you here on RMX.
Hi, thank you for having me.
I know that this is not your first visit to Mexico. I know that Warpaint has a very close relationship with this country. How do you feel to perform again in Mexico City?
I love it. I love any chance that I get to come here. And I think these are some of the best shows that we have ever.
Mm-hmm.
The fans are all so incredible, so passionate, and really add to the feeling of the night. Or, you know, it's special.
Could you describe to me one moment here in Mexico City that it's in your heart? One song that you say, "Whoa, the audience is really awesome, and they know every lyric." Something like it's something to remember and to treasure.
That's the thing, is they're like that with every song.
Every song?
I mean, yeah, they just get into it.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like, I think that's just so important. I don't know if audiences really realize how much they add to an experience, you know? And so it's, I mean, I guess there's probably favorites, but honestly, last time we played, it was like just full force the whole time. People were really excited and I loved it.
When you have a good audience, of course the performance is better.
Yeah, because you feed off of each other, you know. Sometimes if the audience is a little quiet or something, then it's on us to boost our energy and kind of try to get them going, which can be difficult sometimes when you're on tour night after night and you might be a little tired or something, but
it is hard to be on tour.
It is.
It's a hard knock life, like Annie the Orphan says, to be on tour
it's
all the time.
It's a tough, hard life.
I know. It actually is. I probably shouldn't say that too much because it also is so, I feel so lucky, you know, and I get to make money playing music, which is very fortunate.
But it's not also luck.
There is a lot of work, and it's not always on the optimal schedule for performing or being, you know, like getting up. I mean, today is fine because I haven't been on tour. I've been at home and I've been resting and, you know, working and being in my space. So coming here early in the morning doing an interview is fine. But when you're on tour for months and you're really tired, you know, even talking to somebody on a radio show can be a challenge. So, you know, or like making sure your voice is good for singing and, it can be difficult, but a lot of schlepping, you know, schlepping from place to place.
How is a normal day of life when you are not on tour?
For me, well, I like to work on all kinds of things and be at home, cook, be with my kid, study. I wish I was in school.
Are you a good chef?
I'm pretty good.
And
my sister's better. She has a cafe and
a coffee shop.
Yeah, she has a coffee. Yeah. Do you know it about it?
No. What's it about?
Huh?
It would be great. In which part of the world is the coffee shop?
Sister. It's in Highland Park in Los Angeles. It's called Amara Kitchen. It's delicious.
For the next time I go to Los Angeles for Coachella, for example, I can do a scale on Highland Park and go to the coffee shop.
You should.
It will be great.
Yeah, it's really good. You won't be disappointed.
You are right now going to This Girl Festival in Mexico City. What do you are expecting for this performance?
Just loads and loads of fun. I'm excited to play a show with my bandmates and whatnot. We haven't played for a couple months. And
it is easy to get along when you don't play for a couple of months or a couple of weeks.
At this point, yeah. At this point, we're pretty locked in because we've been playing for 14 years. You know?
It's like a family, a routine family.
Yeah, yeah. And it doesn't take us long to get back in that groove at all.
Are you familiar with the other girls that are going to be playing with you?
The other bands?
I know Cat Power. Yeah. And then and I don't really know what Best Coast have been up to lately, but I do. I know them. I know of them. And I know them.
Nice. It's always a pleasure to be playing with other bands that also share like these thoughts of evolving music and showing other kinds of rhythms.
Yeah. Definitely.
Do you have your playlist, your set list arranged for your performance?
No, we usually do that about 10 minutes before we go on.
10 minutes?
Which our sound guy absolutely hates. And our lighting guy hates that too.
But if you're like, I would never wonder that you will setting your set list 10 minutes.
Well, before. Yeah, it's amazing. Well, and it's also a process because I think we've had some of our worst arguments trying to decide the set list. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Your mood takes a big part of it, I guess.
Yeah, it does. And also it's like everybody has a different opinion of what feels good to them and what they need. And certain, like Jen might need to not have, you know, this song and this song next to each other because she has a bass change or she thinks they're too similar. And then I have that same need, but for two different songs. And so it's like a puzzle. It's a Rubik's Cube.
A Rubik's Cube. Are you a professional?
Rubik's Cube. You know it.
You are performing at the first, at the last. In which part of the Girl Festival you are performing?
I'm not sure. Second night.
For the people that will attend the show to get early to see you.
Oh, right. Yeah, we're on Saturday. That's right. So it would be the second night. I'm not sure what time second. We're before Cat Power? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, we're right before Cat Power.
That's great. That's really great.
Amazing. And I also can't wait to see her play. I've never seen her live.
Mm-hmm. So you will be also like one of the audience when Cat Power will be on stage.
Yeah, for sure.
That's great. Yeah. Well, Teresa, it's a pleasure to have you here on RMX.
Thank you for having me.
To see you next Saturday on the Girl Festival.
You're coming?
I will come.
Okay,
yeah,
great.
I have time this weekend, so I will go to the Girl Festival.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll be the ones yelling, hey!
Okay, I'll be looking out.
Okay.
Making sure you do.
Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot to have you here on RMX.